Hey, everybody. Monkeypuzzle here.
Sorry, I couldn't resist.
Yeah, you got your morning voice on there. Can tell. So let me see. We got a level up on the Doty here. Let me introduce you to Baller. Let's give it some more weight. Oh my god, I feel a little flatter now. luckily I survived that, but that shouldn't be so funny if you can do this anyway. That's just as bad, I guess. Oops. Wow. Especially when you run into the torch. Oh, I'm still in K, that's the problem here. Woohoo! Alright, so obviously between episodes, I went out and got a Doty or two, actually, and the lower level one. I found a 92 first. It took me like almost an hour and a half to find the first one. And right when I finished taming it, I saw a 126, this beautiful girl here. So tame both of them with kibble that you saw us making at the end of the last episode. End of the last episode, we tame this wonderful, in the sea of green names over here, this wonderful Ankylo here, Batank. And it's a very nice ankylo. It started at 162. So the lower level one I donated to the town as a community doty. And I think they promptly lost it. Anyway, and then in between that, I actually recorded getting this much further on our base here. But I had updated my recording software, and in the process, my microphone was not listed on it. So you guys get to start from here. So I'll just take you real quickly from where we were before. Before I'd made this gate and the wall, I kind of ornamented the wall and also made it slightly higher, just as I usually do with the railings on it. I just kind of like the look of that. It takes the squareness off of it. And then one of the beauties of Stuctures Plus, from which this is all made, is fences can support ceilings coming off the side of them. So I was able to make this walkway coming out to here.
And that's awesome.
Yeah, it's really neat.
I had no idea.
If you go under there, you can see it's not supported by anything but the fence, which is pretty cool.
And that, so can you go like two foundation or two ceilings away just like normal?
Yeah, that's as far as I could go right there, but it still let me put a ramp on the outside of that. So that was pretty good. And then, yeah, I put all these ramps on this side of it so we can get up from the water easily enough. And then this side in bad dino land, I've got railings over here and our little jumping off point. It's all supported by pillars. The water under here, or the ground under the water, was just not nearly level enough, even with Stuctures Plus, to start from with foundations from down here. You can see over here, if I don't run out of breath, this line right here is going to be the beginning of our aquatic pen going that way. And I had really wished I had tamed a Diplocollis before I did this. We may do it before we finish the pen, because we're not at scuba gear yet. And it was kind of like place one pillar and start drowning, come up for air, and place one pillar. And it seems like the less air I had, the more finicky the placement got. This ARK trolling me. So anyway, yeah, that established the platform for this. And I was playing with the triangles and stuff, and they didn't work out quite how I wanted. So I just went ahead and went for the basic octagon. This has been done many times before, so nothing too new with this, but it still makes a good base for a tower. And this is going to be a lighthouse, if I didn't mention it this episode. So trying to make a base that also has sort of a community function, bringing all the sailors back in from sea. And it also ties into a gate, which we'll start charging a toll for pretty soon as people go through here.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. It'll be a 10 cementing paste, please.
We just need galley eggs. That's what we need.
All right. Yeah. So one galley egg per passage, please. This octagon, if you don't know, you have to set at least two fence foundations to help you exactly place the first dino gate. You don't really need to do that. You could eyeball it, because dino gates snap together. Then you can form the shape with them. But the fence foundations also have the purpose of letting me place walls I did it on every other one because I left these other ones to bring dinos in or to go out and enjoy the view. So yeah, we got four walls in here going up, and then I'm going to use those from which to place ceilings to put the next level up here. So I'm going to have to figure out how that's going. That's one of the things I'm going to do this episode. And something new with the Stuctures Plus dino gates is they actually stack. They're a slightly inset, but usually they're not stackable at all. So I'm going to see how I can also use that. And then in here, we've actually already moved in. Oh, and I didn't introduce you to Levity. This was a 174 pteranodon I saw out there, and we tamed that up with dodo kibble. Took only three. And then instead of using storage boxes, we're using these crafting or these S+ crafting stations because they hold 300 slots, which is a lot. So, and they just take up a lot less room, and they don't block the view through the window. And this is also a S+ smithy. It also has 300 slots, and you could pick it up, and an S+ refining forge, so we could move all the stuff around if we wanted. Got auto torches all over the place to light the place up. And then Aaron went ahead and threw down a fabricator so we can do all that that gives us. And then just one preserving bin where we're still making jerky and keeping our kibble nice and fresh. So I think that's all the stuff to catch you up on. Yeah, new dinos. Harvesting with dinos obviously has helped a lot. We did all this last episode, everything was done by hand, all the harvesting with axes and picks, and even with the metal stuff, that just too much for builds like this. So it's really nice to be harvesting with dinos again. And then one thing I wanted to do right away in the episode is when I logged out here, I actually fell through the floor and died. I had suspected that, so I put all my stuff in here and I didn't lose it. But I was going to go ahead and replace out these S+ parts on the floor here with vanilla, because there was a theory that S+, oh no, I'm full of rocks, that S+ loads in more slowly than the vanilla parts because it's a mod. Whether that was why or not, I don't know, but there's no harm.
Sounds good.
Sounds good. So, yep. Changing them out. So let me finish that real quick, but also real quick, we're going to build a flop house over on dry land to actually log out in, so we don't necessarily face this issue. Let's see, which one are you? You're just a regular stone ceiling. So I'm going to work on that next before I build up on the tower, and I want to use the triangle parts to a better potential for them. I think that's good now for logging out. Let's just get this one. Did I get that one? That's a regular one. Might as well get that one. Let me put these away. Put my toys away so I'm not weighed down here. And then I'll just jump this in here. And then we're this side, we're actually using them to store all the wood, fiber, thatch, and stone, and then to manufacture the S+ parts on. And then in here, I have made some things all the way down at the bottom here. Thought I did. Where'd they go? Aha. Some little wedgie pieces. I'm probably going to get too heavy here. And some regular foundations. Nope, I can move. And use those as the bottom for our little sleeping hut over here. So have an idea for how that's going to go. And it's... Let's start it out. I want to get one of these guys.
Are you going to incorporate that wall into it?
I thought that the back wall should be touching, then it would kind of look like it's a guard turret or something for this.
Yeah, if you knock out any of these, the lower ones, would the top two rows of walls fall down?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, it depends. Actually, those are large walls. And the large walls have to just go one slot down into those fence supports, and they'll stay up. But I think on this side, the large walls went all the way to the ground.
Well, I was just thinking, if you can't get the wall up against it, you could basically have the wall bisect the building, but don't put the wall under the ceiling, you know?
Uh-huh.
So kind of like it was built in, like built into the, into the wall.
I get you. This is pretty close, I think. What do you think about that?
I think it's close enough.
Can we put a wall on the back of that? Let's see.
Should be able to, if you move that torch thing.
You want to pull it off, put it somewhere else?
Yeah.
Let's grab a wall. And let's see. If we do this, of course, we're going to have to get it high enough that we can actually look over the wall. Because it won't be any fun if we can't do that. Go up there and say, who goes there? Taunt them one more time.
So we're going to have multiple towers over here, is what you're saying.
Fart in their general direction.
Hopefully y'all is that a Monty Python joke?
Yeah, yeah.
I've never seen them.
So, the better way, and I'm starving, always when I record, makes me hungry. Apparently, to make circular stuff with these triangle foundations is actually start with them in the middle rather than squares. And so now we got a nice cheese wheel right there. And then off of, is it every one of them? Yeah, off of every one of these sides.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We put.
Then you fill in the triangles.
Yeah. A square. And then we go ahead and fill in the triangles, which gives us a really nice kind of round shape. And you could.
I think it'd be pretty cool without the triangles.
It would be, but we have the triangles. Smaller.
It would be smaller, but it would look pretty cool.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I think this is big enough that we could flop out in the middle, and if a dino clips through and bites, they have a whole space to go through before they bite us.
Oh, yeah, that's fine. We have room for beds and everything in here.
Yeah, so this will be our little flap house, so we'll just go ahead and build up from here on camera. I just wanted to show you that base shape, and of course, there's a lot of different designs for making these even bigger, more elaborate sets of the triangles in the middle, or I could have, like, each one of these squares, I could put another square out and then build out, fill this space with three triangles. Kind of like, I'll just do one. No, not that one. We could do that and that and that and that, and we could have built it out a whole another layer. I don't think we're going to do that this time, but just demonstrating. So I think I caught you guys up. Now I'm going to make some more parts and do some more building and show you. Rather than do it all on camera, we're just going to build up because it'll take too long. And then we'll show you where we get. And if anything significant happens or anything I need to show you, I'll bring you back in. All right. All right, so there's the finished deal. It's still a little bit in the shadows, but you get the point. Nothing too fancy, but still, you know, kind of refreshing shape. Thanks to Stuctures Plus, the doors open automatically, which is a little weird. But you can see that Aaron BLP is crashed out in here just fine. Threw down about 5 beds so that we can come back here up to 5 desks in a row. And then up here, you can see I can take the ladder up. I just repeated the same pattern up here with the triangles and the squares, and then you can look out over here and maybe tame something that's trying to attack you at the walls. And over here I just left these off so you can look straight down and jump off if you need to. So it's pretty cool. It's a little feature I didn't expect to put in, but drowning while I was logged off led to that, and so now we have a safe place to do that, so that's cool. So with that accomplished, let's go over here and see what I can do about starting the next level up here. So there's some challenges to that because I only have the walls going up 4 of the sides because I left gates on the other. I can only really come off of those. So going across is not going to be that big of a deal. We can go ahead and do that. And it seems like it's going to let me come all the way. And it matches up just fine, so I'm pretty happy about that. So we would just repeat that over here. Let me finish all of that. And then let's see what that leaves us. Okay, so that's that side. And then this one. These don't quite match up, but that's okay. It means I just have to come that far with that one. And this far with this one. Now here's the tricky bits, is I have these little triangles left. Not too huge, but I still need to close them up. If I use the square ceilings, okay, that's okay. But then once I get out to there, I'm gonna get these little points sticking out. So let me pull this one back up, and then let's repeat with another one. I believe it would be like that. So that's almost acceptable. We've got just these little things right here. We can take a triangle ceiling, number 7. And we could go like that. Now that closes that off, but it makes this little point here. So let's go ahead and see how we feel about that. And I don't know. I don't feel that great about it. It's a little weird. Like that. So let's go on back up there and take those off. So basically, without sticking out too far, there's no way to really close off these little holes, but I think I'm just going to live with them, because you're not going to fall through. In fact, they just give you a way to kind of spy on what's going on downstairs, and that pretty much closes it up. Now let's see what we can do as far as placing these. Now I was able to place one over there. Let's see if we could snap off of that one. Okay, so and the cycle key is G for Stuctures Plus, but it doesn't work. And Q, the one that comes with vanilla, is working. So that put that there. That's pretty cool. So I'm just going to go ahead and place those all the way around. The ones that had the walls, I should be able to keep going up. Do I have any? I've got one window, so just for demonstration's sake, I should be able to keep coming with that. And then these ones, of course, are still going to need just the gates in order to close them up, because I don't have any walls to build up off of. So I'm going to go up one more level like this, and then I think that's going to be high enough to be the lighthouse. I'm not trying to build a huge tower. I mean, I could repeat this a third time. I'll decide. But let me finish this up and get up there, and we'll see what we're going to do in the next step. All right. Well, that's the finished look with the second level. That second level actually is going to make a great pen for flyers. I think that's just not quite tall enough. I could do it like that, but I think I'm going to put a third level on, and then we'll figure out how to cap it off. Got one little piece had to stick out there because of the hatch frame there. Anyway, we won't look at that anymore. So I went ahead and got the tower all the way up 3 high. You can see below me. And then I've been doing a bunch of playing with how I want to make the top level, the glass level where the light's going to shine out of. I kind of wanted to make it project out a little bit so that you can stand out here and look down. I know it's not the classic lighthouse look. The classic lighthouse, this part would probably still be in line with down there. But I think I'm going to do it this way. To do this, I want to show you really quickly. I had to place fence foundation so that I could place above these dino gates here. Now, I couldn't place them directly here, but if I placed ones here on the edge of these ceilings, I was able to do that snap, that 135 degree snap over to here. And then another quick tip is that the S plus stone fence foundations would not snap to a ceiling to get them just right. So rather than freehand place them, I went ahead and used the regular stone fence foundations, and those still do snap, and it was fine snapping from there to there to get that. So now I have a place that I can come off of. And now to make this happen, what I have to do is I put thatch here, Which, these are actually facing the wrong way. Can I flip them? Hopefully that won't mess things up too much. And we'll do this one too. These, you know, the regular fence foundations don't give you the indicator which way they're pointing when you put them down, like the S plus ones do. So I could probably do this from above, but just so you can see, what I do is then from down here, I go ahead and I place a couple stone walls, and except that's not what I meant to do. Oh, you know, one trick I haven't shown you yet is that S plus has these different guns that do different building functions. This one here is the demo gun. And so if I pointed at this, it should have gone in. Oh, it took the wrong one. Okay. There we go. Goes into my inventory, which is pretty cool indeed. And it also works on vanilla stuff. That was an S plus stone wall that I could have picked up anyway if I could have reached it. But things like chests or generators or fabricators or building parts or whatever, you can pick up with this thing. Or if you got a lot of stuff up really high and you don't like it and you want to take it down, it's cool. And it's instant too. You don't have to deal with the timer that you do for picking stuff up. So that's pretty cool indeed. And I think there's even a setting on it where you can have it demo stuff rather than pick them up if you don't want them. So this gate is high enough that I don't think that's a problem. I'm gonna leave those there like that now. And I did that with the rest of these, and you can't even see it when you shut the gate. But I think that blends in fine. And then what that allows you to do is, I don't want you, go away, is it allows you to go ahead and place a ceiling sticking out from here. That's just the basic mechanic for placing ceilings. They go out from either the top. You can't place them at the bottom of a wall, but you can if another wall is hanging down like that. So now I can go ahead and place that there. And let's get over here. And that there. And now I should be able to take this off, but before I do, I usually don't have to do this, but I'm going to do it this way anyway, just to be safe, is from back from there. Now I can place a ceiling there and there and fill in those ugly triangles. So that's pretty cool. And now so far I've been able to safely pick these up and all that stuff stays. So that's pretty cool. And then from here, what I'm doing is that, and that, and that, and that. And then we've got the good old sloped ones. And we'll put one over here. And then I'm going to put the sloped ceilings like that. So that's pretty cool. Now, what I chose not to do is try to fill in between them. You could kind of do it with the triangle piece, but the triangle piece is made for a 12-sided figure, and this is an 8-sided figure, so it didn't quite line up, and you got this overlap, and it just didn't look good. So I'm just going to do it like this, and plus that allows me to put the slope ceilings on. Not quite sure what I'm going to do once I get in here, but yeah, that's how I'm going to do it. So just wanted to show you all that and where I'm going to take it. So let me finish putting these together, and then I'll bring you back for, I think, what's going to be the last scene. I think we're hitting finish build for now. There's plenty of detailing that will be added, and just kind of like moving in. Things like Aaron B has placed the industrial grill here on the outside because it takes so much space, and breeding sabers and taming things like crazy, and he got galleys so we can get the eggs for those so that we can get, oh shoot, I forget what they're for now. I knew it a minute ago. Yeah, so like I said, I'm going to finish this up and I'll meet you back at the end. So I got that outside part all done, and now I just need to put a ceiling on it, which is harder than it looks because it takes a lot of metal and crystal and cementing paste to make all this. If I didn't mention it, this is a specific glass tier of Stuctures Plus that you can make that has, I think, the durability of metal, but it looks kind of like the greenhouse parts, and there's a lot of different models of styles that you can choose from these. I'll show you those in a minute, but two get ceilings going off of sloped roofs, generally you put a thatch roof going backwards from them up there, but it's not working in this case. But if I put one there, and then I put one there, I don't have another thatch ceiling, so I'm gonna go ahead and use a stone one there. So now I'm able to take this off and take this off, and then I can build out from here with my ceilings. So that's pretty cool. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that and bridge across, and then when I get to the overlap pieces, I have a plan, and I'll show you when I get there. And just so you know how to get this piece out, since you can't get to it, you can just use your little demo gun and it's gone. Pretty cool. Oh, and get the demo gun out of your hand before you try to place anything. Otherwise, it's trouble. And here's just a quick example of it picking up something vanilla. And you can see that it is in my inventory right there. So that's pretty cool. And I found out you can do it even easier. There's two snap points here, by the way, or at least two. Put it on the upper one, and then you can actually just do this and just do that, and you're good to go. You can take these off. I'm just doing it this way because sometimes I mess up and delete the wrong thing. All right, we're just about done here. I'm just going to put these last two on right here. And you see, though, we have this like horrible mishmash of pieces up here that are all overlapping. And it just doesn't look very good at all. So we have this model gun here in my 7th slot. And what it does is you could do this manually clicking on each piece, too. But if you shoot that piece, I can select from all the different models that you can choose for these pieces. So I'm going to choose the ones with no sides. And I think now there is a way to do it where it will choose it every time. Although this is not that hard either. Maybe if I right-click this thing? Let me figure out how to do that. But anyway, you can see that we can just get rid of some of these. And they're still there. But they go all clear. No side. So I'm going to figure that out how to... Well, you can kind of see them there. I'm going to figure out how to get this to select the same one every time. And then I'm going to keep eliminating until it looks decent. I figured it out. You press G while you're looking at the one you want. Well, I had said it had it set, so that just cleared it. But now that one's set. So now it'll do that to all the rest. That's pretty cool. And I can pick any combination of sides and make this look good. So I'm going to figure it out, and I'll show you when I'm done, and we'll check out. All right, everybody, time to wrap it up. Right in the middle here, I'm going to place this platform smithy just because it looks so cool. And I think it'll make a great table. Put some chairs around it. We'll wine and dine up here as we look at the view. So I eliminated a bunch of the struts to something I think makes structural sense. I may still eliminate some, but that's a great feature. Not everything lines up perfectly, but that's just ARK for ya. Okay, so the sun is going down and all the auto torches are lighting up. You can see I put a bunch in the upper level there too. So there it is. That's the completed build. You know, we'll still elaborate and change things, and we still have to put in the harbor here as well, but basically, that's fleshed out for our first initial build, my first time using Stuctures Plus. We have our little base as part of the town here at Gaming Evolved. So, yeah, we've got our little tower on land, so we have a place to sleep without risk of drowning. We've got a nice wall and gate here to help separate out the rest of the wild from the town. It was just keeping out this pesky 156 Raptor over here, so it's being put to use already. And then, yeah, over here we've got the lighthouse, which is looking pretty nice right now as it gets really dark. So there it is. I hope you liked it. And if you have any questions or suggestions or comments, please leave them down in the comment place. And I will see you in the next episode. This has been Monkeypuzzle. Bye-bye.